Good evening, everybody. This is one of our favorite times of the day, the midnight sessions. These are genre films, films which are a little bit quirky. We love these films on TV Festival. And personally, I love these films. This evening's film is called Arctic. It's directed by Joe Penner. It's his first film, but he's filming a very experienced actor who's called Max Mikkelsen, whom we all know. And they are going to be on the red carpet this evening. We've had plenty of things going on today to keep us all awake, but here we are now live again for the red carpet for the film Arctic, directed by Joe Penner and starring Mads Mikkelsen. It's a film all about survival in the North Pole, exactly the type of film we love. Well, let me just see what's going on behind me.
Je crois que c'était juste la musique en fait.
Oh, it's just the music.
Le film donc de Joe Penner.
So this film called Arctic describes how Mads Mikkelsen survives in the snow after a plane crashes in the North Pole. How's he going to survive? It's a little bit like that film with Robert Redford a few years ago, which we saw here in Cannes, where Robert Redford was on a sailboat and it overturned and he had to survive. Here we are in the snow with Mads Mikkelsen, who is simply trying to survive. The film is called Arctic, and the festival goers will be seeing it in a very short while behind us in the festival hall. So here all the festival goers are heading towards the movie theater.
Voilà donc. Arctic, le film de Joe
the film is called Arctic. It's directed by Joe Penner. Let's take a look at the trailer, then you'll know what we're talking about. Off we go for the trailer.
Voilà donc, vous l'aurez compris, Arctic.
So there we go, the film Arctic, a survival movie. It's quite a unique genre. There aren't many films of this genre. Arctic is quite a unique film.
Comme disait ma grand-mère, plus on cherche à rentrer dans le moule, plus on ressemble à une tarte, et ce n'est pas du tout le cas.
So it's always a good idea to stand out with a different type of film.
Dans quelques instants,
and the festival goers will be discovering a unique film here this evening. Mads Mikkelsen spends most of the film on his own, battling against the elements.
Un premier film étonnant de maîtrise.
And this is the first film by Joe Penner. It's extremely well mastered. You may know Joe Penner from YouTube. He's Mr. plays music on YouTube. He's got millions of followers. And he's learned how to make films, and now he has set himself up on the road to filmmaking. The direction of photography is wonderful, dazzling light in the snow. And Mads Mikkelsen, of course, we're all familiar with because he won the Best Actor for The Hunt here in Cannes some years ago.
Mads Mikkelsen qui sera avec nous dans quelques instants.
Mads will be with us on the red carpet any minute now.
Et voilà, il va se débrouiller pour survivre pendant cette heure et demie.
And let's hope Mads Mikkelsen manages to survive the next hour and a half. Lost not in the Arctic, but in the movie theater. On the film, he's got no food, very little survival kit.
À sa phrase fétiche, Dieu sema le blé, et Marc Lavoine. Mads Mikkelsen, qui a donc gagné
Mikkelsen le prix won
meilleur acteur,
the Best Actor Award here in Cannes, the Thomas Winterberg film, The Hunt. That was in 2012.
Mads Mikkelsen, qui a été membre du jury.
And Mads Mikkelsen was also a jury member. That was in 2016. He was in the film Michael Colas in 2013.
Est revenu en 2014 avec The Salvation.
That was a film directed by Arnaud de Palière. And then he was in the film Salvation, directed by Christian Levering in 2014.
Dans la neige, mais on n'est pas du tout Jeux Olympiques, hein. En même temps, c'est bien parce
he's back in the snow, but we're not at the Olympic Games this time. No skis in this film.
Mads Mikkelsen qui sera avec nous dans un instant. Mads Mikkelsen,
Mads Mikkelsen is due to arrive any minute now.
Mads Mikkelsen qui est venu plusieurs fois à Cannes.
Mads Mikkelsen has been to Cannes on several occasions.
Mikkelsen qui a démarré sa carrière avec un
he started his career
révélation de Cannes puisque
in Cannes with Nicholas Winding Refn,
ses premiers films Pusher justement avec
Mads Mikkelsen. That film was called Pusher in 1996
avant de venir en sélection officielle.
And then he came back to Cannes in the official selection with the film Drive, which really blew the minds of all festival goers that saw it.
Immense,
he's a great actor, Mads Mikkelsen.
Vous verrez quand vous pourrez voir Arctic en salle.
When you see Arctic in your movie theaters, you will realize how great he is. It's not only a physical performance that he puts in for this film, because he's in the cold, he's surviving.
Mais c'est extrêmement
but it's also very subtle. And his acting is extremely intelligent. At the beginning, he has hope, but as time goes on, he loses hope slightly, but he does not give up. There's so much to read in his face, but I'm not going to give any more away. It's a really well-constructed film. It's the perfect film to be watching at midnight here at the 71st Cannes Film Festival. The crew from the film is arriving now. We've got the National Police, which escorts the crew. And here are the official cars.
Voilà donc l'équipe qui est arrivée. Mads Mikkelsen, qui est avec nous.
Mads Mikkelsen is in Cannes this evening, greeting the fans. He's a regular here in Cannes. And we'll hopefully have a word with him in a short moment. But we'll let him prepare. And then we'll have a quick word to one of the greatest actors in his generation, Mr. Mads Mikkelsen. We'll allow him some time to go and sign photographs. The director, Joe Penner's here. Perhaps we'll have a word with Joe.
Hey, Joe, how are you?
Good, thank you. Great to see you.
Great, thank you so much.
How do you feel before like showing the movie to the world?
It's just incredible. We did a technical rehearsal yesterday, and seeing the film up on the big screen with the sound, it's just, this is where it's meant to be seen, and it was just amazing.
That's
that's an unbelievably spectacular movie. I mean, this must have been so difficult to make with so much stuff you had to take care of. How to approach a project like that?
I mean, you have to find the right crew. You know, you have to find the right cast. If we had someone who was more cranky all the time, or somebody who didn't give it its their all, you wouldn't be able to do that.
You mean this guy?
This guy here.
How are you?
Hey, Matt, how are you?
Not too bad.
How was it to work with Monsieur?
It was amazing. It was a fantastic script, fantastic story, and a fantastic vision. And we did it in 19 days. And now we're in Cannes.
19?
19 days.
Wow.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
It was unbelievable, and now we're in Cannes. And that's like, we could never have dreamed of it.
You guys, when you're freezing your asses over there, do you think of Cannes? Do you think of being here? Or do you think of just finishing the damn day?
We finished. I was thinking about how do I survive today, you know? But no, you don't think about that. You think about how do we make the best film right now? What is the best for the film? And then perhaps one day, you know, you can dream, but no, this is just surreal. This is amazing.
Matt, it's very difficult. The survival movie, it's a genre very difficult because there's not much dialogue, there's not much things to do, but you have to survive. You have to give everything through the faces and through the movement. How exciting is it for an actor?
Well, I think it's very exciting. I mean, I've always been a fan of silent movies, and I believe that it's called movies for one reason. I mean, it's motion picture. And I think we're just going back to the basis here. There are some words in here. There's a few.
Well, how many words do you have to say in the film?
I don't know. Did we count the words?
How many words does he have to say in the film?
I mean, it can't be more than 50, 60?
Yeah, but they're great words.
What you didn't know is that you are paid by the word.
No, exactly. Oh, now that's you tell me.
We had to delete all the words. You couldn't afford mass otherwise.
At least they didn't cut me out. That's good.
Okay, being in Cannes for you is like your home, is it?
No, it's not my home. It feels like home, but I am visiting, and I'm proud every single time. And this time I might have been the proudest moment because first time director, and I think this is amazing what we achieved.
I mean, there's just so much trust that Mads put in me, and that I had to put into Mads, you know, to pull this off. I mean, he is alone in the film for the vast majority of the film. He's having to pull that performance together and tell the story. So.
And then someone comes up in the film. Could you introduce you to our friend? How are you?
Hi, I'm good, thank you.
How is it to be in the snow with this gentleman?
It was amazing, you know. He's super humble, super Danish as well, and really grounded. So I couldn't imagine a better co-actor as a start. Yeah, definitely.
Question for all of you, and after I let you go, do you feel that making a movie is an experience in survival also?
Great question. I mean, yeah, we definitely felt like that for us, you know. We were trying to survive just the tournage. It felt like we were all doing it together, you know, much like the film. It felt like we were all doing it together and being able to survive together.
All right, I got to let you go. Merci beaucoup. Merci infiniment. Merci. Au revoir. Très bonne montée des marches.
Enjoy the red carpet.
Et voilà donc toute l'équipe de Arctic.
There we have the whole crew from Arctic live on TV Festival at midnight, and you're still with us at midnight on the red carpet.
L'actrice avec qui nous avons parlé, c'est Maria.
The actress
Thelma.
We were talking to is Maria Thelma Smaradottir.
Trop vous dire parce que je vous laisse le mystère, le suspense quand vous verrez le film.
I'm not going to say what role she plays in the film, but at one time or another in the film, Mads isn't alone on screen. Mads is always very charming, happy to speak to us.
Et la montée des marches.
Now we have the red carpet.
Ah, petit départ en avance. On va rejoindre toute l'équipe. On va rejoindre Joe.
Full start there. Let's head back to the start line.
On va pas relancer le carnaval des animaux.
Where we have the music, the carnival of animals, and the red carpet can begin for the film Arctic.
Mads Mikkelsen, accompagné de son épouse.
There we have Mads with his wife.
L'équipe de Arctic.
Arctic, donc. Le film réalisé par Joe
the
Pena.
The film is entitled Arctic.
The YouTube account.
The director is Joe Pena, famous on YouTube.
Pour arriver en haut des marches de Cannes.
Roads to Cannes.
Mads Mikkelsen, qui est un petit peu le symbole de l'acteur hétéroclite qui peut tout jouer.
Mads Mikkelsen is such a versatile actor. We saw him recently in Doctor Strange, if you remember.
The
Marvel superhero film. He was doing all kinds of strange antics with his hands. He had really great fun playing the baddie.
Maintenant, on ne peut plus dire ça maintenant, ça n'existe plus vraiment les bottins. Donc. Et voilà, Joe Pena.
Here we have Joe
et
Pena.
Mads Mikkelsen.
With Mads
en bas
Mikkelsen.
Des marches du palais.
On the red carpet here in Cannes.
Joe Pena, donc, premier film, étonnant
This
premier
is
film.
Joe Pena's first feature film.
La première fois que Mads Mikkelsen est venu à Cannes, c'était
the
en 2009.
The first time that Mads came to Cannes was back in 2009.
En clôture, si je me rappelle
and
bien, c'était Coco Chanel et
the
Igor
film
Stravinsky.
That he was acting in that year was Coco Chanel and Igor Stravinsky.
Le film de Jan Koonen.
Directed by Jan Koonen.
Ensuite, La Chasse, en 2012.
And then he came for The Hunt in 2012.
Okay, il a gagné le prix d'interprétation masculine.
He won the Best Male Actor Palm for his role in that film. Then he came back in 2013 with the film Michael Kohlhaas, directed by Arnaud de Pellier. Then The Salvation in 2014. A Christian Levering film. And then he was a member of the jury in 2016, so that was 2 years ago.
Voilà donc toute l'équipe.
On your screen you have the crew from the film Arctic.
Joe Pena.
Joe Pena is the director.
Et son acteur, Mads Mikkelsen.
Mads Mikkelsen, the actor.
Tandis que l'actrice du film.
And the actress Maria from the film is called Maria Thelma Smaradotti.
Devant les photographes. Une actrice islandaise.
The actress comes from Iceland.
Tout jeune, premier film.
She's a young actress. This is her first feature film.
Second film, elle avait un tout petit rôle dans Prisoners. Voilà, Joe Pena et Mads Mikkelsen qui attendent leur actrice pour monter les marches avec elle.
Joe and Mads are waiting for Maria so that they can go up those steps together.
Voilà donc toute l'équipe d'Arctic en bas des marches.
The crew from Arctic on the red carpet.
Première séance de minuit
this is the
de
first
ce festival.
Midnight
on
session of the 71st Cannes Film Festival. We've got another one tomorrow. There's a Korean film tomorrow night. And there's another film the night after that at midnight. So we've got quite a series ahead of
et
us.
Il y en aura un autre samedi, mais on va en parler dans un instant puisque Thierry Frémaux accueille.
Tomorrow night it's The Spy Gone North by Yoon Jong-bin.
Mads Mikkelsen.
But tonight,
et le réalisateur,
at midnight, we're here
Joe
for
Pena.
Arctic, directed by Joe Pena.
Voilà donc toute l'équipe. Et donc un autre film de minuit, ce sera samedi.
On Saturday, there's another midnight film.
Un film produit pour la télévision en Amérique, mais pour la salle en Europe, Fahrenheit 451.
Which is produced for movie theaters although TV in the States. It's called Fahrenheit 451. It's directed by Ramin Barani. And it stars Michael Jordan from Black Panther.
Ryan Coogler a
donné Ryan Coogler is here in Cannes, so I'm sure the two of them met to chat. Ryan Coogler was doing a masterclass this afternoon.
Black Panther sera diffusé au cinéma de la plage.
Black Panther will be screened on the beach.
C'est hier soir, voilà.
Or in fact, it was screened last night on the beach here in Cannes.
Et on terminera les montées des marches de minuit avec un documentaire
and
sur Whitney
our
Houston.
Final Midnight Steps will be a documentary dedicated to Whitney Houston. That's next Wednesday evening.
On va rentrer dans la salle avec eux. Il y aura
but
une
let's get back to Arctic.
Vous allez voir,
on the red carpet this evening. We've got a bit of a surprise waiting inside, and unless I'm mistaken. Let's see what's awaiting us inside. We're heading into the building with the crew from the film Arctic.
Voilà, on rentre dans la salle dans un tout petit instant.
And we will be in the movie theater very, very soon with Mads Mikkelsen and director Joe Penner.
Voilà donc. Thierry Frémaux qui salue.
Thierry Frémaux, ça.
L'actrice d'Arctic qui précède son réalisateur,
Maria Thelma.
Joe Penner qui rentre en premier.
The director.
Ici,
Joe Penner.
Les stars, ce sont les réalisateurs d'abord.
We're only keeping Joe, Mads and Maria. All the others, you can get to your seats, please.
Voilà donc mise en place pour l'entrée dans la salle.
Getting ready to come into the theater. We'll stay with them. And there's going to be something special once we get inside there, because we are at a midnight session, so don't leave your screens.
Allez vous reposer. Enfin non, il y a un jour à Cannes avant, donc bougez pas. Tout ce qui s'est passé dans la journée résumé
after
en 26 minutes.
Their entrance into the movie theater will be looking forward to tomorrow, and then we'll also be looking back at all of the exciting things that have happened today. And then you can go to bed, of course. But for the time being, there's Joe Penner on your screen. First film. First feature film.
Voilà, on va écouter l'ovation du public.
Let's hear the applause as the crew enters into the movie theater.
Allez-y Thierry, faites-vous une petite place.
Thierry Frémaux is making his way to the front of the room.
Et oui, séance de minuit, Thierry Frémaux monte sur scène.
Yes, Thierry Frémaux usually has a few words to say in this night's session. Let's see if we can hear what he's saying.
Moi. Ça suffit. Comme on est dans une séance de minuit, on fait toujours des exceptions. Pour ces séances de minuit, en appelant l'équipe, d'abord je voudrais leur souhaiter à tous la bienvenue, les scénaristes, les producteurs, toutes les gens qui rendent possible les films, puisque le cinéma est un art collectif, mais c'est sans doute pour Mads Mikkelsen que j'avais envie de faire un remerciement particulier, un accueil spécial, et j'espère que vous m'y aiderez. Je voudrais d'abord... Attendez... Non, Mads était membre du jury il y a quelques années. Il est là beaucoup, c'est un grand cinéphile et c'est un grand cycliste aussi. Bon. Je voudrais que vous accueilliez une jeune actrice qu'on voit dans ce film. Vous ne la connaissez peut-être pas, vous la connaîtrez un peu plus, évidemment, après le film. Faites-lui une ovation. Maria Thelma Smavadottir. On terminera par le metteur en scène parce que c'est un premier film et c'est important. La caméra va d'abord vers l'acteur principal presque unique de ce film. On est sur la croisette, il fait beau et pourtant dans le film, ben vous verrez, Mads Mikkelsen. Je suis presque déçu. Non, d'habitude, le public des séances de minuit. Non, mais du coup, je vous disais, c'est l'homme le plus important, ou la femme la plus importante à Cannes, ce sont les réalisatrices ou les réalisateurs. Je vous disais, c'est un premier film. Vous avez accueilli Mads Mikkelsen et Maria Thelma très bien. Maintenant, une ovation pour le réalisateur de ce film, puisque c'est une première mondiale, Joe Pena. Et on vous souhaite une très belle projection. Bonne soirée.
Et voilà la projection.
So there we go. The screening can commence. Inside, I'm staying outside because tomorrow there is a major event in the afternoon. There's a red carpet for the film by Jean-Luc Godard. And we're wondering, will the director be there or not? Will we be able to speak to him or not? We do not know. We do not know whether he's going to catch the plane to come down to Cannes or whether he's going to stay in Switzerland. At home. Now you'll find the answer to that question tomorrow at about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So I'm going to wait here. I'll have a bit of a rest and then just wake me up beforehand and we can listen to the interviews and see the photo calls and go to the press conferences. There's so much to do tomorrow and it's all on TV Festival. So we'll be back tomorrow. Time for sleep now.